Thanks, Lydia. Building on what Lydia just discussed, we'll talk now about how the thesaurus is used in indexing ERIC records and how the thesaurus then aids in searching. Descriptors from the thesaurus are assigned to every ERIC document. If you have seen an ERIC record, you have seen a list of ERIC descriptors. You can see them circled here. Every record, with very few exceptions for early records, have at a minimum three descriptors assigned to them. That minimum really only applies to records where no full text and the skimpiest of abstracts is available. Otherwise, ERIC records contain the number of terms necessary to adequately describe the content, no more and no less. Descriptors reflect the content of the document regardless of the language used by the author. The field of education in all of its facets contains what I call squishy terminology. As Lydia mentioned earlier, terms and phrases change meaning over time, cross paths between older and newer phrases, come and go with the latest thing, and one word can have different meanings in different contexts. Only one or two terms are used to index a particular subject. That means that all documents on that subject will be indexed with the same term or terms. For example, in the record pictured, the author uses the term primary school students in the title. And we know that primary school students are the same as elementary school students. So the record in the lower circle, you can see, has been indexed with the descriptor elementary school students. Descriptors reflect the specificity of the document to the greatest extent possible. For example, if a document is about high school students, it will be indexed with the descriptor high school students, not a broader term like secondary school students or just plain students. Now, users often ask us, how do thesaurus terms get assigned to ERIC records? In general, there are three ways to approach indexing: automated, machine-assisted, and manual. Automated indexing eliminates the human factor completely, and terms are assigned by a text reading program that has been trained to pick up keywords and concepts matched to a controlled vocabulary. This approach works best for highly precise vocabulary, such as found in medical texts or perhaps psychological texts. Machine-assisted indexing uses a program to suggest terms, but an indexer reviews and makes adjustments as necessary. This approach is helpful to the degree that the terms in the text can be closely mapped to the controlled vocabulary, and the program can make discernments between different meanings. Adding the human element ensures that inappropriate suggested terms are eliminated and missed terms are added. Thirdly, in the manual approach, all assignment of terms is done by a professional indexer. A human must look at each record and know the thesaurus well enough to select the terms most appropriate for the content of the text. ERIC uses a combination of manual and machine-assisted with professionally trained indexers. Most indexing is done manually. Machine-assisted indexing is used to help improve indexing consistency in cases where certain indexing terms are always used together. Assigned ERIC descriptors reflect the subject of the document in hand, whether it's a journal article, report, conference paper, or any other accepted form of content. ERIC indexers use all available information to assign descriptors to each document. In some cases, all that is available to an indexer is the title of the document and the abstract. Now, titles can be helpful and descriptive, or in some cases, they're very clever but totally not useful for indexers. So abstracts are key elements in indexing because they describe the content of the document. Abstracts are either provided by the author or publisher of the document, or may be constructed by an ERIC information specialist. When available, the full text of the document is also consulted for concepts not included in the title or abstract. So now that we know a little more about the thesaurus and how it is used in ERIC indexing, let's get searching. There are two main ways the thesaurus helps enable resource discovery in ERIC. You can use descriptors to help refine your search, or you can use descriptors to start your search. Now don't worry, you don't need to know specific descriptors to benefit from using them in your search. You can search ERIC using any criteria you like, then use descriptors to narrow down your search results. The ERIC search results page displays additional search criteria on the left-hand side of the screen. You see that circle. A list of descriptors assigned to the records in your search results appears just below the section on publication date choices. You can select a descriptor from that list by clicking on it, and your search results will be altered to display only the records that include your keyword and are indexed with that descriptor. For example, a search for the keyword dropout results in 16,022 hits. On the left-hand side of the screen, you can see that these records have been indexed with a variety of descriptors, including dropouts, dropout prevention, and dropout rate. If we select the descriptor dropout prevention, the search is narrowed to only those records containing the word dropout that are also indexed with dropout prevention. This has narrowed the search to 3,465 records. You can then continue to use descriptors to narrow the search even further until you get a set of records that meets your needs. You can also use a descriptor to start a search. To start your search with a descriptor, you will first need to find a descriptor to use. You can easily access the ERIC Thesaurus on the ERIC website. Simply click on the tab on the ERIC homepage as circled, and from here you can either search or browse the thesaurus. To search the thesaurus, enter your search criteria in the box and then click on the search button. To include synonyms in your thesaurus search, click on the Include Synonyms checkbox just below the search box. As Lydia discussed earlier, synonyms serve as guides to descriptors, so it may be useful to include them in your search. Once the search is complete, you will see a list of all thesaurus terms that contain your search criteria. In this case, we've searched for the word reliability and retrieved 5 terms. The synonyms appear in italics. From this list, you can select a term to see its complete entry. So another way to access the thesaurus is to browse it. To browse the thesaurus, click on the Thesaurus tab on the ERIC homepage, then click on the Browse Thesaurus link to the right of the search button. You can browse the thesaurus alphabetically or by category. To browse it alphabetically, simply click on one of the letters and all of the thesaurus terms starting with that letter will be displayed. Here we can see the display for the letter Y, which includes the terms year-round schools, yearbooks, young children, and youth programs, amongst many others. From this list, you can select a term to see its complete entry. Now, you can also browse the thesaurus by category. If you remember, these categories are broad subject areas that are used to link conceptually related terms. And as we saw earlier, every descriptor is assigned to a category. When you select a category, you will get a list of all descriptors that are assigned to that category. In this example, we've selected the arts category, which includes the descriptors art education, dance education, graphic arts, music appreciation, and theater arts. From this list, you can select the term to see its complete entry. Once you've found the descriptor you want, whether through browsing or searching, you can use it to search the ERIC collection. It's easy to do. Just below the category section, you will see a link that says, Search Collection Using This Descriptor. Simply click on the link, and the search is automatically generated for you. So in this slide, we can see the search results for the descriptor Art Education. This shows us every record in ERIC that has been indexed with the descriptor Art Education. From here, you can use the techniques we discussed earlier to refine your search using other descriptors. So remember, the thesaurus is a discovery tool. It reflects the actual content in ERIC and helps assure that all relevant records that include a specific concept, regardless of how the author has used terminology, can be found. So, Aaron, I'd like to turn it back to you now for the wrap-up.